Several weeks ago, we posted a review video of the Anker 3-in-1 MagSafe Cube. It's so compact, but can charge 3 devices at the same time. Many of you guys are requesting for the teardown of this little cube, so let's take it apart to see what it looks like inside and why it can be so small. First, tear off the sealing sticker and open the box. Except for the MagSafe Cube, it also comes with some documents, a charger, and a cable. This is a 30W USB-C GAN charger with foldable input prongs. The charger that powers ZKM003C shows it supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, SFCP, PD 3.0, DCP protocols. And it also has 5 fixed pedals of 5V, 9V, 3A, 12V, 2.5A, 15V, 2A, 20V, 1.5A. As for the dual USB-C cable, its length is about 1.5 meters. Back to the MagSafe Cube. The matte surface can resist fingerprints, and the metal hinge on the back makes it more exquisite. The indicator light and USB-C port are on the other side. The top MagSafe panel for iPhone is foldable. You can adjust its angle up or down. The charging area of your AirPods is under the top panel. The wireless charging panel for your Apple Watch is hidden on the side. Just press the button slightly and it'll pop out. As for more specific specs info, you can click the upright corner to check that. The size of this cube is about 64x60x60mm, and the weight is about 406 grams. You can place it vertically or horizontally, which is very suitable for the standby mode of iOS 17. After a brief introduction, let's take it apart from the bottom. Tear off the rubber pad and remove those fixing screws. The main PCB is fixed with screws. Then remove the hinge. Use the spudger to remove the wireless charging panel of the AirPods. And remove the small PCB of LED light. The wireless charging coil and the thermistor are pasted inside the panel. Then disconnect all wires from the main PCB. The top panel for iPhone can be separated from the bottom cube. Continue to take out the plastic frame in the middle. The wireless charging panel for your Apple Watch is hidden here. We can clearly see how it works. It's locked by a hook in the middle. A slight push can unlock it, and the module will be pushed out by 2 springs. An iron block for keeping balance is at the bottom. Flip to the back. This little magnet is for fixing. Then let's see the wireless charging module of Apple Watch. We also took apart before. You can click the upper corner to check it. Heat up the module so we can separate it out. Here is the charging coil covered with an induction sticker. And it's fixed with thick glue. The charging coil and the yellow-black wires are soldered to the small PCB. As mentioned, take a closer look at the LED light. Next, let's take apart the MagSafe module for iPhone. First, remove fixing screws on the back. The Apple official MagSafe module is inside the panel. We also took it apart before. You can click the upright corner to check it. Like the Apple Watch charging module, the MagSafe module is also fixed with glue. There is a layer of copper foil on the back of the module for shielding. The yellow wire is for grounding. Separate the MagSafe module. Only the back of the Apple's MagSafe module is equipped with a neat black PCB. Slowly remove the metal PCB shield. Finally, let's take a look at the main PCB. It has three box circuits for wireless charging of three devices. Flip to the back. The small PCB soldered on the right is the Apple Watch wireless charging circuit. Firstly, let's see the box circuit for the AirPods charging module. This is the mass control chip from MAXiC. It integrates USB PD, QC, and other fast charging protocols, and it complies with the Qi standard. The MOSFET for voltage regulation is from FETek and adopts a PRPAD 3x3 package, 30 volts, 14 milliohm. This is a 6.8 microhenry alloy buck inductor. Both solid capacitors for Apple featuring are from SG Gather, 100 microfarad, 16 volts for each. The full bridge circuit consists of two MOSFETs from FETek. 4 ampere resistance capacitors are connected in parallel. Then let's see the buck circuit for the iPhone MagSafe module. The synchronous buck converter is from ETA Semi. It integrates MOSFET and has a 35 volts input and 3 amp output. The switching frequency is adjustable. This is a 10 microhenry alloy buck inductor. The final part is the buck circuit for the Apple Watch charging module. Its buck converter is marked with TY2A. This is also a 10 microhenry alloy buck inductor. And as mentioned, here is the Apple Watch wireless charging circuit, which is placed in the hollow of the PCB. This custom chip is used for voltage regulation of wireless charging. An SMD inductor is next to it. This MCU is from STMicroelectronics, which integrates 80 MHz ARM M4 processor and 256 KB memory. Two half-bridge drivers from Texas Instruments are next to it, used to drive MOSFETs. The LED light is connected to this connector. Well, that's all components of this 3-in-1 MagSafe Cube from Anker. After taking it apart, we found that the internal space is fully utilized. From top to bottom, it has Apple's official MagSafe module, AirPods charging module, and Apple Watch charging module. All three modules are connected to the main PCB at the bottom. It has the same performance as Apple's official charger, but it is smaller and more convenient to use. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!